Philippine Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles confirms the case of Mary Jane Veloso, a Filipino sentenced to death in Indonesia, was discussed by Manila's top diplomat Enrique Manalo and his Indonesian counterpart. But Angeles says she is not aware if the issue was also discussed in the closed-door meeting of Philippine President Marcos and Indonesian leader Joko Widodo.
The president wants us to speak with one voice. And in matters of international relations, or even in relation to the status of Filipinos working abroad and possibly in conflict with the law, then these matters, which may have an effect on our international relations, must be coursed first for its messaging with the DFA.
Philippine progressive groups held a protest Monday near the Foreign Affairs Department in Pasay City, urging the Marcos administration to work on securing Veloso's release. The Filipina overseas worker was put on death row after she was convicted on drug trafficking charges, but Veloso's family claims she was framed by illegal recruiters. Veloso was granted a reprieve in 2015 with the help of then-President Benigno Aquino III. The proposed 2023 budget of the Philippine Agriculture Department undergoes congressional scrutiny. House lawmakers questioned agriculture officials on the budget's lack of fertilizer subsidies and more funds for farm-to-market roads. Vivian Gulia reports.
Despite appeals from some sugarcane farmers for fertilizer subsidy amid soaring prices, the Department of Agriculture's proposed 2023 budget shows no allocation for such initiative under the Sugar Regulatory Administration. Kabataan Partidist Representative Raul Manuel questioned this during the House Committee on Appropriations deliberation of GA's proposed budget. Some sugarcane growers recently said the higher fertilizer cost is among the factors that pushed sugar prices up.
Wala sa proposal ng DA yung ganito, given na sobrang taas na rin ang presyo ng fertilizer na ginagamit na ating mga sugar planters, mula 800 per bag e ngayon nasa 3,200 per bag.
We have only 1 billion, not 2 billion for under the NIP. So titingnan po namin, Madam Chair, kung paano po namin gagawin, no? Ayusin based on the allocation ng budget under the NIP.
Agriculture Undersecretary Domingo Panganiban added the SRA allocated funds for loans to sugarcane growers. Camarines Sur 2nd District Representative El Rey Villaferte also flagged the DA's 13 billion peso allocation for farm-to-market roads next year, which is 75% higher than the 2022 figure. Villaferte questioned what he claims is a disparity in the allocation of the funds among provinces.
Cueva is yes, number one, Isabela two, Camsur is three. Can you safely say in the formulation of the farm-to-market allocation, these provinces were given priority? Because as I was studying the budget, there were a lot of provinces, with all due respect to our colleagues, that got higher allocations and they're not rice producing.
Actually, yung formulation po ng FMR is not only anchored on rice but on the totality of production areas, all commodities involved.
Villaferte also complained about the low funding for irrigation.
I'm really sorry, Madam yes. Chair. Ang nandito lang po talaga is for 2023, is 40 million. I'm not complaining for me, for others also. Isabela, Nueva Ecija, Iloilo, Tarlac, who are also rice producing. We want to boost the production of rice, and yet they give us 40, 50 million.
The National Irrigation Administration told lawmakers the devolution of communal irrigation systems poses challenges for some local government units in terms of operations and maintenance. NIA is planning a partnership between LGUs and the national government on setting up these communal irrigation systems. Gabriela Representative Arlene Brosas meanwhile raised what appears to be mixing of the funds for cash assistance to farmers with an infrastructure fund.
Hindi nakasaad na exclusively lamang gagamitin lamang para sa cash assistance ang excess revenue mula sa RCEP. Hinalo po ito sa purpose number one na maaaring gamitin pa sa iba pang programa tulad ng Support to Infrastructure Project and Social Programs o SIPSIP. Tama po ba?
Sa support to infrastructure projects, opo. Ito po ay nakalump dun sa support to infrastructure and social program, mainly because hindi po natin kaya nga po kagad ipakita para pong ganon. I think there is already an agreement between, you know, among these agencies that automatically, because of this 11598, that excess revenue automatically goes to DA for distribution as cash assistance to the rice farmers.
BROSAS proposes to increase the budget for NFA's rice procurement and increase the buying price from the current 19 pesos per kilo. The total proposed budget allocation for the agriculture sector next year is over 184 billion pesos. Of this amount, 163 billion is proposed to go to the Department of Agriculture in an effort to revive the sector. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.